The NBA is creating a bubble campus to keep the players safe as they bring back the season for the playoff push. It's in Orlando. It has a maximum capacity of 1,600 people. That's for all the players, the coaches, all of the NBA staff. Players will be restricted to bringing 3 family members with them that have to stay in the bubble. They can't leave. They can't go back and forth. The NBA is going to test every player every day. And if a player tests positive, they have to go into quarantine for a minimum of 7 days. That's a big deal. Because in a playoff series, in 7 days, that's 2 to 3 games. And depending on what round you're in, it might even be 4 games because they do have an accelerated schedule. So if you miss 2 to 3 games, your team might get eliminated from the playoffs. Imagine that. Imagine the Lakers. LeBron gets it. He tests positive. Now he can't play for 2 to 3 games? Nah. That's why all the players, they have to take this bubble seriously. They can't leave. We just saw the Michael Jordan documentary. Dennis Rodman, he was taking a little vacation, even in the NBA Finals. There's not going to be any Dennis Rodmans in 2020. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine being the player that ruins the series for the Lakers, for LeBron James, for any of these contending teams? You're going to be hated. You're going to be the most hated player. You got to behave. You got to stay in that bubble. And even before the NBA negotiated all of these details, I think it was Jared Dudley for the Lakers. He said they're going to protect LeBron James and Anthony Davis like their life depends on it. These guys are going to be royalty. They're going to be able to work out whenever they want by themselves. They're going to be by themselves. The NBA is not going to put ankle bracelets on players. They're not going to put any type of tracking devices. They're just going to trust that these players are going to be professional and they're going to stay in the bubble. And the NBA Players Association, they seem confident that their players are not going to flee this environment. Because if you're a championship team, you're going to have to be there for almost 3 months. From the end of July, you're going to go August, September, October. That's a lot of time to be in this bubble. It's easier said than done to not leave maybe for a day or for a few hours to go and do something else. But they are confident, the Players Union, the Players Association, that's not going to happen. So let me know what you think in the comment section. Will there be some drama with testing, with somebody messing it up for other players? Leave your predictions in the comment section and let's see if any of them come true.
For the record, they got a hacker call. All I got to do is make 1 free throw for the record. Who is Wilt Chamberlain? Who is that? Moses Kerr. He's from the hood. Can I?